Hello everyone, welcome back to Tenorshare channel. After using a period of time of your iPhone, did you notice your iPhone is getting slower than before? Don't worry, today I'm going to show you a few steps on how to improve it. Your iPhone getting slower usually because of two general problems. 1. Hardware issue. iPhone could get slow over time, so if your iPhone is used for more than years, the hardware of your iPhone got aging, like battery. And your iPhone would get less smooth, it is inevitable. If laggy only appears when you are using a certain app, you should update, delete, or reinstall it. If you drop your iPhone before or any other movement that may potentially cause your iPhone hardware damaged, and it appears to be slower than before, you might need technical repair. Go to support.apple.com find help. 2. Software issue. Except for hardware issues, there are a lot of things that could cause your iPhone slow. For example, you might be running out of storage, your software version is outdated, your app malfunction, and so on. All of these could cause your iPhone slow. Now I'm going to show you a few steps to improve it. All of the following operations is for speed up your iPhone. 1. Clean up your storage. Go to Setting page. Tap General and tap iPhone Storage. Check this page. See what's taking up your storage space. For me, I will delete books, podcasts, because I never use it before. Also, you can offload the app. It will delete app, but save the data. For other app is the same way. At least save 2 GB storage for your iPhone. 2. Clear your Safari history and websites data. Go back to setting page. Scroll down, tap Safari, and scroll down, tap clear history and website data. Be careful, this will remove your history, cookies, and other browsing data. 3. Do some setting changes. These setting will cause your iPhone slow. Turn off some background app refresh. Go to setting page. Scroll down, tap general, and tap background app refresh. This function allows certain app to download new content in the background when you're not using your iPhone. So check for which app you don't want it to download new content in the background. I chose books, no TS, podcast. You can choose whatever you like. Then go back setting page, scroll down, tap mail. Tap accounts, and tap fetch new data. Turn off push. Change fetch option to manually or hourly or every 30 minutes, it depends on you. Go back to setting page again, scroll down, tap privacy, and tap location services. Not every app needs to access your location all the time, you can change them to while using the app. Now tap system services. You can also turn off the option you don't need. Scroll down, make sure you turn off these 3 options. Go back to home screen, get in the app switcher. Close up the app you are not using. Some of the app might taking too much performance in the background. And then go back to home screen. It got to be some widgets you don't need, just delete it. Too much widgets also will slow your iPhone. If above methods is not working, please follow next step. 4. Check for an update or reset your iPhone. If your software version is too old, it may have some bugs that developer already fixed and you don't know, so update your software. Or you can reset your iPhone directly. You can go to setting page, tap general, scroll down, tap reset, and tap reset all settings, enter your password, and it will reset your iPhone. But I recommend a tool that can reflash your iPhone and remove some cache, and also can repair some potential issues that you don't know. It's called Reiboot. You can go to tenorshare.com, click products, and click here to download Tenorshare Reiboot. When the download is complete, connect your iPhone to PC, open Reiboot, click start, click standard repair, and click download. We'll download the latest version of iOS firmware. When the download complete, click start standard repair. It will start reflash and repair your iPhone. Just wait for the process complete. It will not cause any data loss. It's easy. This is the tutorial on how to speed up iPhone. If you followed one of these methods and succeeded, don't forget to give us a thumb up. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next video.